Hey guys, I hope you're having a wonderful day because in this video, we're going to be talking about the new Audi multimedia infotainment displays that we get in the latest models of Audi cars such as the Audi A8L, the Audi Q8, and in this video, we're going to be using the Audi Q8 to explain these displays. Now, the Audi multimedia system is essentially a dual screen touchscreen system this time, and it packs a whole lot of features which we are going to be talking about in detail. Also, as we are using the Audi Q8 as the demo car for the displays, and we're with the Audi Q8, we also will be dropping down a complete review of this car. So consider pressing that red subscribe button to join our family for watching one of the most detailed reviews of every single car that we review. And a very special thanks to Audi Chandigarh for lending us this Audi Q8 for making this video possible. They have an amazing inventory of many Audi cars, even pre-owned ones. So if you are interested to buy any Audi car, hit them up using the links in the description below. And with that said, now let's not waste any time and get on with the video. So first I'll talk about this display and then we'll move on to this display over here. So about this display, it's the infotainment display of this car, and as you can see right now we're in the home screen, and one feature that I really like is of this quick access bar that we get over here, which always remains the same wherever you are. So if I go into media, this quick access bar will still stay over there. For example, I urgently wanted to go into navigation. Well, I can just press this button and I'm in navigation. Similarly, if I want to go to the home screen, I just press that button and I get to the home screen. So this quick access bars is really cool, and one of the best features of the displays in Audi is of haptic feedback. That's for those people who say that this car has a touchscreen system, no one can compete with the actual feel of buttons are the best. Well, you know what, Audi has done the best. Haptic feedback in this car is so top-notch that it actually feels like you're pressing an actual button. So that I am in love with. But anyways, we're gonna start with this area over here first off, in which we have the notification settings, then we have the date and time, then we have all the bunch of things that are turned on in this car, like the Bluetooth, the profile, and as you can see, it's a small little one over there that depicts that profile one is turned on, and then we have that secure maps location over there. And so what I was telling you about profiles, that can be changed from here. Now obviously it happens a lot of times that this Q8 is not only for one person, and a lot of people in your family drive it, so you can set driver profiles. So all these profiles can be adjusted to any person, and that time, for example, say I am in profile one and I change a bunch of different settings in this car, whenever I turn into profile one once again, all those settings will be as it is. Similarly, if in profile 2 there are different set of settings, whenever this car will be turned on into profile 2, at that time all the vehicle configuration and the settings will always be configured according to profile 2, which I think is really, really cool. But anyways, let's go back. Coming to this area, we have this small little Wi-Fi thing. That's not actually for the Wi-Fi, it's the phone connection, which is sort of the Bluetooth. I don't know why they've given this Wi-Fi connection over there. As you can see, it then gives us the option to connect to the different displays in this car. Anyways, once we go back over here, then we have settings, and then we have audio, which we are going to talk about in this display through settings over here and then telephone over here. If I talk about car settings over here, then we get our main functions, that is the Audi Drive Select, which can be adjusted according to this over here or through these small little touchscreen buttons that we have been given over here as well. So right now that the car is in off-road mode, I could change it from here, or I could just press this button, and as you can see, now I'm in all-road. Similarly, if I press this button once again, now I'm in efficiency. So this is just like the shortcut over here, so that when you're driving the car, you don't need to fiddle around with the display, you can just easily do it from here. So that I think is really cool. But anyways, we get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7 different drive selects in this car. All of them have their different things, but keep in mind that the off-road mode is only for the SUVs such as Q8, but in the Audi A8L that we have over here, that car doesn't get off-road because, let's face it, that car isn't an off-roading car. We also have another feature of raise in this. For example, right now the car is going into its lowest position, but if I go into off-road, As you can see, the car is now going to start raising itself according to the off-road situation. So that's really cool as well, because we get air suspension in this car. Anyways, going back, we get car details. So if we go into car details, this is sort of for the off-roading people, in which we get the actual real-time representation of the car. Right now we're at a flat plane, that's why it's 0 degrees and 0 degrees. But if you were, say, off-roading at that time, if your car is a little bit tilted, at that time it would tilt the Audi Q8. Once again, a little Easter egg for you guys, it's an actual representation of a Q8 and not just any generic car. So that's why this is like for the off-roaders, in which it gives us the actual elevation and the altitude of the car, the coordinates of the car according to the compass, the actual coordinates according to the map, and at what degree the steering wheel is at. So if I start rotating the steering wheel, it will show me at what angle the steering wheel is rotated at. So that's pretty cool as well. But anyways, let's go back into efficiency assist over here, in which we have accelerator pedal feedback. Once again, this is for the efficiency, so that you get the best efficiency from your car. So according to how you press the accelerator pedal in this car, the car would start giving you notifications. So you know, you get the best efficiency. It'll start giving you tips to not do that or do this. Similarly, economy tips, it'll start giving you tips in the way, like, you know, start driving at 60 kilometers per hour so that you get the best fuel economy of your car. Going back into seats, in which we have easy entry for driver's seat. You can turn it on or off. Right now it's turned on, and what it does is that right now the car is on battery power. Now that I've turned off the car, as soon as I'm going to open the door, you can see the steering wheel is going up. Now this gives me enough leg room to get out of the car so that my legs don't bang into the steering wheel over here. But anyways, we're going back into the main menu for climate control. So if I go into climate control over here, I can turn it off. I can turn the control the rear climate controls from here. I can also control the max AC. So if I press max AC over here, the car is going to blow off the maximum air. And then we have sync, because we have 4-zone climate controls in this car, two for the front seats, two in the back seats. So you can control everything through this display. This is actually just for controlling which area you want. For example, if I press rear over here, now these controls are going to control the rear AC in this car. So that was about the climate controls in this car. We can go back into the lights and vision. Now first, talking about the exterior lighting in this car, we have automatic headlamps, which is a great feature, and then we have entry and exit lights. Now what that means is, as soon as you press the unlock button on your key fob, the headlights in this car would turn on so as to greet you. And similarly, when you press the lock button, the car headlights would still be turned on for like 10 or 15 seconds so as to say a goodbye to you. So that is really cool as well. But anyways, we can go back and then into background lighting. So if I come into background lighting over here, we get the different type of selections for the colors for the interior lighting in this car. As you can see, it's given all around the car. Well, if I go into drive select, it actually changes according to the driving mode that you're in. So like, for example, you're in dynamic, it's going to make everything red because, you know, you're in a sporty mode. But then you also have presets like the contour, and that it makes the whole thing white. As you can see, it's white right now. If I go into, say, solar, it's going to make everything kind of orangish red, as you can see right now. So these are the presets. But then you can go into individual as well, in which you can press this button to control what color you want. So if I go into contours over here, I can change out of the 30 colors that the Audi Q8 has. So that is really cool as well, and I can always set the brightness as well. So that's really cool. And as you can see, the haptic feedback is in working over here. I mean, you can't see it, but I can actually feel it, and I'm telling you that as soon as I am pressing any preset over here, the feedback is given to me via the screen. And if I go into the very edge of or brighter, at that time the display gives me a small little jerk telling me that this is the limit, it can't go further than that. So let's just go back, and then we're going into parking aid, in which we have automatic activation. That means as soon as you turn this car into reverse, the parking cameras will totally turn on and will help you parking the car. And now we have front volume and rear volume. Because this car has parking sensors in the front and the rear, which is obviously, it's a really expensive car, we can actually control the volume at what we want the sensors to beep at. So as you can see, if I do low, the volume is really low, but if I go into high, the volume turns up a little. Similarly, in the rear volume, if I turn it low, the volume is low, but if I turn it high, the pitch is really, really high for the rear sensor. So I'm just going to put it back into medium that it was. And then we have the entertainment fader, which means that when you're playing music in your car, obviously, you want the music to turn down while you're parking the car because you want to focus on the driving at that time. So how much entertainment fading you want, that intensity can be chosen from here. Let's just go back and then we're going into driving assist. So in driver assist, we get speed warning. So the speed in this car warning has been set to 100 right now. So that means whenever your car would exceed 100 kilometers per hour, you will get a warning on your display that you're driving too fast. Please slow a little bit down. So that's really cool. And then we also have rest recommendation. So if you're driving like for 2-3 hours straight, the car would start giving you notifications that you have been driving for too long, just, you know, park down somewhere and then take a little bit of rest because you've been driving for a really, really long time. So this is also a very, very good feature. Let's go back, and then last but not the least, we have settings and service, in which we have the settings for everything in this car. For example, we have steering wheel button. This is one of the best features that I've ever seen, and that is of a customizable button that you get on the steering wheels over here. Right now, this star button, this is the customizable button. So you can customize what this button would do. Do you want the button to switch off the radio media? Well, if you press this, that's what the button would do. Do you want the button to turn on or off the traffic announcement? If you press this, well, that's exactly what it's going to do. So we have a bunch of different options on what that button is going to do, and I think it's a really, really cool feature. Anyways, let's go back, and then we go into central locking. So central locking in this car, once again, through the key fob, you can choose what everything would do. Like, for example, you have fold mirrors. Do you want the car to automatically fold and unfold the mirrors while you're locking and unlocking the car? Well, just press this and that is exactly what it's going to do. And so you have a bunch of different options on what the key fob in this car is going to do regarding the central locking. Then we have car information, but when you open it, it turns on the chassis number along with the other information about the car. So due to security reasons, I'm not going to show that. But anyways, that's regarding the chassis number and all that stuff. Then we go into tire pressure loss indication, in which say, for example, you have this kind of thing that one of your tires is leaking. You can actually know it from the tire pressure loss indicator. Now what you need to do is just store the tire pressure once. So whatever the tire pressure would be in four tires, it would store that information. And then say after 2 or 3 hours, you can come back and check what the tire pressure of all the four tires is. And then we have oil level, that tells us the engine oil, so I'm not going to tell you about that. And then we have the service intervals, because you need to get your car serviced every year or every 15,000 kilometers, so it's going to give you information regarding that. And then we have air suspension trailer. Now what this means is, for example, if you're using this car to tow a trailer with you and you want the air suspension to do it according to the trailer, well, just press this and the air suspension would adjust itself according to what it would when you're towing something with the car. And then similarly, we have air suspension wheel chains. For example, you're getting your wheels changed. At that time, you can get the air suspension to be ready for that and just press this button, it would be ready for that. Then we have wiper change position. Now right now the wipers have been tucked in the hood of this car, but if you want to change your wipers, if you press this, as you can see, the wipers are now in this position, so it makes it easy for us to change the wipers in the car. And so next up is of settings, in which we have settings obviously for every single thing in this car. For example, we have general settings, and you can choose the date and time, the measurement units, the reminder of signal for wireless phone charging, allow command during speech, version and legal information. All this is very standard. And then we have our display brightness, once again changing the brightness of the display of the virtual cockpit. Like, for example, which display you want to choose in the virtual cockpit in this car. But I have made a separate video for the virtual cockpit, so go check that out. Link is in the description below, so I'm not going to waste any more time on this screen over here. And then we have the MMI, which is this setup over here. So if you want to change the brightness and the contrast, you can do it. Then you have the screen feedback. So if I press this, then have haptic feedback and acoustic feedback. So if you like the haptic feedback, well, it's been turned on. But if you don't like the haptic feedback because you have to press the display like an actual button and you don't want that, well, you can just turn it off. And then acoustic feedback has been turned on. Now, whenever you touch the display, it's not going to give you any haptic feedback, just sound in your car. Then we have screen cleaning mode, in which you once press this button and activate it, both the displays have now been turned off and you can easily clean both the displays. And if you want to turn it off, just press and hold this button and the display then turns on back. itself. Then we have language and input, so that's pretty standard, let's not waste time on this. Then we have sound in this car, so if you want to change the bass, the treble, the balance fader, the subwoofer, the focus, which is in the front seats or the rear seats, or like a movie, which is surround sound. And then you can choose how much surround sound you want. Do you want to turn on 3D sound? Yes, you can. Do you want speed dependent volume control? Yes. Everything regarding the sound is given in the sound settings. Then we have the announcement and sounds. So volume of the spoken cues, you can control how much volume you want. Greeting sound, whenever you turn on this car, it makes a sound of a little sound. If you want to turn it off, well, you can just do it from here. But if you want the sound to be really, really loud, like this, you can turn it to the maximum. But if you want it somewhere in between, just do this. And the volume of the greeting sound has been adjusted. So let's go back into system maintenance, in which we have the software updates and the reset to factory settings. So that's pretty standard as well. Go back into the users, like if you want to turn on the users, like for example, like I showed you the profiles of profile 1, profile 2, profile 3. If you don't want that because you're the only one who drives the car, well, you can just turn them off and they won't bother you. And it does take a little bit of time because it's essentially changing the UI, but eventually it happens, and then you can turn it back on if you want. So if I activate it, it activates really fast, but it takes time to turn it off. Anyways, let's go back, and then we have our connected devices, which I showed you earlier. Then moving on over here, we have connection settings, which once again is pretty standard. Radio settings are very standard. Media settings such as the Bluetooth audio, the CD, the USB, all that is very standard. Then we get into navigation, once again very standard stuff, which is available in every single display. So let's not waste time on this part over here. Going back, we have telephone. Once again, we get contacts, the mailbox, dialing a number, favorite contacts, call list, like that is the call logs. And then we have search, in which you can search a contact which whom you want to call. So that's pretty standard as well. Let's go back into navigation. Navigation, once again, pretty standard navigation. Wherever you want to navigate, just press search over here, and then you can put in the destination where you want to go. And one really cool thing is that because we have two displays over here, Audi has made use of it. Now right now, if I turn on in destination over here, it gives me either a keyboard, like an essential keyboard, or I can just scribble it down as well. Like for example, if I do Z over here, as you can see, it registers a Z. Similarly, if I want to put I, it registers an I. So that's pretty cool as well, because it sometimes it's easier for the person just to scribble it down, not actually find where individual letter is, especially when you're driving the car. So this is a very good idea. Anyways, let's go back into radio. Once again, radio settings, very standard, which radio preset you want, such as 94.3, 92.7, or whichever is prevalent in your area. Then we have media for the USB, the SD card, the external connected devices, that is through Bluetooth and all that stuff, which is very standard. Then we have phone apps over here, which can be used only if your phone has been connected to Android Auto or Apple CarPlay. So that makes every single app available on your phone over here, so which again is really cool. Then we have our help over here, in which we have the setup wizard and the usage tips, in which it gives you a small little demo on how to use the two displays in this car. But anyways, let's just go back. And then last but not the least, we have users over here. So if I press this, we have activate profiles, that is of guest. For example, you have already set 4 profiles in this car, like I showed you before. But then you're giving your car to some guest who's not going to drive your car every single day, but just needs it for, you know, 1 or 2 quick trips. Well, then you can activate the guest profile in this car, and it would give them a completely new type of UI for them to drive the car, with fresh settings, and everything according to them can be set in the guest profile. So that is also very cool, and you can also select a profile from here as well. Anyways, let's go back into the last but not the least, the messages, which shows you the messages that you get on your connected device. Like right now, an iPad has been connected, so if I want to check out the text messages on the iPad, I can do it from here, but obviously I won't do that. So that is what this display has to offer. It's a very intuitive and a really cool display, in which Audi has made everything so clear cut and very good. So if I talk about this display over here, which is essentially for the AC controls, and it's always going to stay here. So once again, what you need to do is use this display to control the AC. If you want the air from above as well, you can choose that. In the footwell, you can choose that. And if you want to turn off for these vents, you can do that. So once again, it's pretty standard for how to use this display, and they've made it very, very intuitive, which is really, really nice. And once again, you also have the haptic feedback for this display, which I think is a nice touch. But one little Easter egg is that, for example, I want to change the temperature. I can keep doing this, which is very tedious, or just keep hold of it, which takes a lot of time. But the easier way is just swipe down over here, and then you can swipe to change the temperature. And I think this is pretty cool. Similarly, for this part over here, you can change the fan speed by simply swiping and then change the fan speed however you like, which I think is a really cool feature. But this display is not only for the climate control. You also have a bunch of different options over here, such as turn off the automatic turn off switch. Now what this is actually a switch to turn off your car at stoplights so as to save your fuel. But a lot of people don't like this because it essentially turns off the AC as well. So if you don't want this feature, just press this and the auto cutoff feature has been turned off. Then we have our hill hold control over here, and then we have our parking assist over here. So if I press this right now, it's going to say currently unavailable because of the car is right now switched off. It's in battery position and the ignition has not been turned on. But if the ignition would have been there, I could have chosen parking assist, and the bunch of different cameras in this car, all of them would turn on and I can see where everything is. So this is also really nice. Then we have this button over here in which we have the presets for the FM, and I can also customize this. For example, I have this 103.1 FM preset over here, and this is one preset that I use a lot. So instead of going into radio then choosing that, I can simply just press this button and then choose this, and 103 would turn on. Sorry for the copyright issues, but anyways, you can do it from here. And similarly, I also have this My FM. I can press this and My FM would turn on. So this is the presets and the favorites tray. Then we have our screen off button, like I showed you before. As you can see, the screen has been turned off. Similarly, I can turn on the screen from that button as well. And so that was the review of the multimedia system that we get in the latest models of the Audi cars. Well, my favorite feature was of the haptic feedback by far. I love that feature. What do you guys think? What was your favorite feature? Well, tell me in the comments down below. Anyways, the Audi multimedia system, I think, is a really, really great system because the user interface is like really, really easy to use. It's not hard for anyone to navigate around this display. And I think that is one of the trademarks that every single company should use, because in the end, it's the customers that are going to use the display, and Audi has nailed it. So that was our review of the multimedia system. If you like this video, please give us a thumbs up. Comment down below what your favorite part was. And if you want us to improve on something, well, we're open to suggestions. Share this video as much as you can. And a subscribe would also be appreciated. Thank you.